Here's what happened to the US stock market last week. Trade progress between the US and China boosted US stocks. The major indices rallied as the Trump administration struck what it called a substantial trade deal with China. The S&P 500 gained 1.09% on Friday to close at 2,970.27. For the week, the index advanced by 2.05%. The US President Donald Trump said China and the US agreed to the first phase of a broader trade deal. He said the terms of that phase will be written over the next 3 weeks. Stocks hit their session highs on that comment, with the Dow briefly soaring by more than 500 points. The Dow jumped by 1.21% on Friday to end the week at 26,816.59, with a 2.35% gain compared with the preceding week. As part of the deal, China will buy between $40 billion and $50 billion worth of U.S. agricultural products. Trump also said the deal includes agreements on foreign exchange issues with China. In exchange, the U.S. agreed to hold off on tariff hikes originally scheduled for Tuesday. In the meantime, the Nasdaq Composite advanced by 1.34% on Friday to 8,057.04. For the week, the tech-heavy index gained 2.35%. On the data front, University of Michigan's preliminary consumer sentiment report came in at 96, above economists' estimates. Meanwhile, the U.S. import price index climbed by 0.2% last month. The cost of goods imported into the U.S. rose in September for the first time in 4 months, but most of the increase stemmed from higher oil prices. Market sentiment was also buoyed after the Federal Reserve announced that it would buy $60 billion of Treasury bills every month, at least into the second quarter. The central bank also said it would conduct overnight repurchase agreements at least through January of next year in order to reduce pressures in funding markets. In corporate news, Roku shares surged by 4.71% on Friday after Citadel Securities disclosed a 5% stake in the streaming device maker. Roku also got a boost from an RBC Capital Markets upgrade. The stock soared on Friday to close at $121.60, posting an 11.72% advance on a weekly basis. Roku stock has surged 300% so far this year, but analysts argue that the shares have more room to run. Meanwhile, among stocks in a downtrend, shares of Vox International Corporation fell by 0.9% on Friday, even after the technology manufacturer reported that its operating losses fell in the first half of the year. The international manufacturer and distributor in the automotive, audio and consumer accessories edged down on Friday to end at $4.43. For the week, the stock, however, advanced by 1.6%. You've watched the latest financial markets review on InstaTV with me, Anna Kasatkina. Stay tuned.